Engineering a pump that will perform reliably for years is important. Gorman-Rupp RotoPrime self-priming centrifugal pumps do just that. These pumps are specifically designed for pumping petroleum products, petrochemicals, and solvents. An innovative feature incorporates an integral variable capacity vane pump that quickly and automatically evacuates air and vapor. This makes the RotoPrime ideal for loading or offloading transports, as well as stripping hoses when needed. RotoPrime pumps come in a variety of sizes and styles. RS series pump models incorporate a single cutwater volute casing. These models operate at 1450 RPM on 50 Hz or 1750 RPM on 60 Hz and achieve maximum flows of 1425 gallons per minute or 89.9 liters per second and maximum pressures to 156 feet or 4.7 bar. RD series pump models are available for higher operating conditions and feature a double cutwater volute design. These models operate at 2900 RPM on 50 Hz and 3450 RPM on 60 Hz and achieve maximum flows of 925 gallons per minute or 58.4 liters per second and maximum pressures to 390 feet or 11.7 bar. Built of durable ductile iron or optional cast steel, with permanently lubricated bearings and a self-lubricated mechanical seal, RotoPrime pumps are actually two pumps in one, a variable capacity vane pump used during a priming cycle, and a standard centrifugal pump to move liquid to dynamic operation. The priming pump quickly and automatically eliminates air and vapor from the suction line and volute. The centrifugal portion of the pump moves liquid to meet system design requirements. The variable capacity priming pump is the heart of the RotoPrime's integral priming system. Pressure from a spring on top of the movable slide block holds the priming pump in full pumping mode. This causes air and vapors to be drawn in through the volute suction and, depending on the model, through holes in the hub of the impeller. It then either passes through a kidney-shaped opening in the body cover or through a priming tube connected from the suction to the priming pump. Air drawn into the priming pump is compressed and passed through the external bypass tubing and exhausted into the discharge, downstream of an internal priming assist valve. The eccentricity of a slide block that surrounds the vaned rotor determines the priming rate. With the slide block at its maximum eccentricity, the priming pump can deliver up to 18 gallons or 68 liters of air handling capacity per minute under atmospheric conditions while running at 1750 RPM. With the centrifugal portion online and all air and vapor expelled, the impeller creates liquid flow and differential pressure. Pressure is exerted back around the slide in the group grind to the underside of the slide block and shifts the priming pump into neutral. While in neutral, very little liquid continues to pass through the vane pump. Depending on the configuration of the pump, a priming assist valve is built in the pump discharge to prevent recirculation of the air and vapors during pumping cycles. The priming assist valve will not prevent drain back through the priming pump. An external system check valve is recommended in most systems. Applications often require pumping against substantial back pressure or static head. When back pressure exceeds 8 psi or 5.6 meters, an optional BAR configured pump is required. This model includes an externally mounted air release valve, which enables a Roto-Prime pump to prime regardless of the static head. The pump operation remains the same during the priming sequence, with the exception of air and vapor being routed to the priming pump from a priming tube on the suction inlet. For enhanced priming characteristics, priming through the impeller and body cover are not utilized in any BAR models. A discharge tube from the priming pump is routed to the air release valve, which allows air and vapor to be exhausted. This valve should be routed to a collection tank. As air and vapor are removed and flow begins to fill the chamber of the air release valve, an internal float within the valve body will raise a control rod. Close an air exhaust port and open a return port at the bottom of the valve. This allows liquid to be drawn back through the pump inlet. As the impeller moves liquid, building differential pressure, the priming pump shifts into neutral. Should air and vapor enter the pump, the priming pump will automatically shift into priming mode, and the air release valve's float will lower to its priming position until all air and vapor is eliminated again. A system discharge check valve is required in the discharge piping system for all BAR pumps' priming systems to function correctly. A variety of options are available for Roto-Prime pumps to meet specific application requirements. When you specify Gorman-Rupp, you're getting more than the right pump for the job. You're getting an experienced design team, the best craftsmen and service people in the industry, educational resources, and the support of the whole Gorman-Rupp company with every purchase of a Roto-Prime pump.